So, hello students, in last video I explained how we prove that the vertices of the triangles form the special triangles. Same things for the colored triangle. If I say if A x1 y1, B x2 y2, C x3 y3, and D x4 y4, and if no any 3 points are collinear, no any 3 points are collinear, so they form a quadrilateral. Always you write in the cyclic form A, B, not C here, C here, C, D. A, B, C, D or A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. Either side, but always in the cyclic form. So if all four vertices are given and the question want to prove that it's a special type of quadrilateral. So, you know what's a special type? First thing, you find all the sides. Length of sides AB, BC, CD, and AD. All four sides you can find it. Here you can also find the length of diagonal. Length of diagonal. So, what's the diagonal? That is AC and BD. You know what is symbol of this? They all means you can find the length of AB by using distance formula AB. A coordinate and B coordinate, distance between them, that is called length AB. After finding this sixth length of this quadrilateral, that is the first diagonal, that is the second diagonal. AC and BD. Then, for first, for parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. AB is equal to CD and BC is equal to AD. So it is a parallelogram. For parallelogram, no need to find the diagonal. Only opposite sides equal, you directly write down, it's a parallelogram. For rhombus, you know, all sides are equal in rhombus. Means, if you find all the length of the sides and all four lengths are equal, you say it's a rhombus. I know you have to think that, sir, why not a square? So we explain. Wait and watch. For rectangle, opposite sides equal as in panorama. Also, diagonal equal means both pair opposite sides equal and diagonal is equal, so it is a rectangle. Fourth, for square. All four sides are equal. Also, diagonal equal. So you can say it's a square. Okay? Means for rhombus only all sides equal, but for square, this diagonal is also equal. If the question won't only prove that it's a rhombus, so no need to find the length of diagonal. Let you think, sir, what's the figure? That is a parallelogram. These two opposite sides are equal. For rhombus, all sides are equal. For rectangle, opposite sides equal and diagonals also equal. For square, all sides equal and diagonals also equal. In some question also say question, find the area also. So area of parallelogram is not possible to find only the length of sides or diagonals, because its formula is half into base into height. So base is not given, but we can write the formula. Area of parallelogram half into base into height. This height. Here height is not given. Area of rhombus half d1 d2, half into the length of both diagonals product. Area of rectangle, I hope you all know, length into breadth. AB into BC or any two consecutive, any two adjacent sides product. Area of square side to side, any side, or also either this is or this is, both is the formula, because area of rhombus and area of square is same. Square is also a rhombus, but all square is not a rhombus, but all square is rhombus, but all rhombus is not a square. So for the square we can use the formula to find the area of rhombus, but here we can't find area of rhombus by using area of square formula. So these are the four concepts. We write one more concept in space. I have, yes, you have try to write this step. For trapezium, for equine formation, trapezium concept is removed from your syllabus. We only explain for your knowledge. You know what is trapezium? One pair of sides are parallel. So only area of triangle ADC, area of triangle BDC means between the parallel lines the area of triangles are equal, so you can say it is a trapezium. So these all the concepts for proving the special types of collateral by using distance formula. Accept this, pause the video, note down. So we explain both the concepts, how we prove that special triangles and how we prove that special collateral. So both concepts we have to explain by taking one two examples. Identify the types of triangle with vertices. This means the vertices of triangle are given and the question one, find the types. Which types of triangle they form? Solution: A 4, 0, B -1, 1, C 3, 5. So first thing we can find AB, BC and AC. Length of all three sides of triangle. First AB, then 4 - 1 whole square plus 0 - 1 whole square. That is 4 + 1 whole square, 1 whole square. 5 square + 1, 25 + 1. √26. This is the length of first side of triangle AB. Then BC. BC -1 - 3 whole square, -1 - 5 whole square, -4 square, -6 square. 16 + 36 √52. Length of second side BC. Then AC 4 - 3 square, 0 - 5 square, 1 square, -5 square, 1 + 25 √26. So, without any tension, without any problem, you can identify that AB and AC are equal and BC not equal. If two sides equal, that is isosceles triangle. Very good. AB is equal to AC, so triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. But it might be possible ki it can also right angle triangle. So check it. Longest side and the remaining side. Pythagoras theorem. Longest side √52 square, 26 square, 26 square, 52. Verified. So, or you say, hence, triangle ABC is an isosceles right angle triangle. This is a full solution. 3 marks question in board examination. Pause the video and note down any important questions. See one more question. For explaining the quadrilateral types. 4 points ABCD are the given. So that it's a parallelogram but not a rectangle. Parallelogram means, you know, if ABCD opposite sides are equal. But if diagonals also equal, so it is a rectangle. So the question what? It is a parallelogram but not a rectangle. So without wasting time, first we find the sides. One minus five whole square, zero minus three whole square, minus four square, minus three square, 16 plus 9, 25, that is 5 unit. BC 5 minus 2 square, 3 minus 7 square, 3 square minus 4 square, 9 plus 16, root 25, that is 5 unit. CD 2 minus minus 2, 7 minus 4, 4 square, 3 square, 16 plus 9, 25, that is 5 unit. AD 1 minus 2 whole square, 0 minus 4 whole square, 3 square plus 4 square, 9 plus 16, 25, that is a 5 unit. So AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD. So it is a parallelogram because AB is equal to AC and BC is equal to AD. Opposite sides also equal and all sides equals rhombus. Yes, but rhombus is also parallelogram. So it's proof that that is a parallelogram. If the question one proves that rhombus, so yes, it is a rhombus. And find diagonal AC. 1 minus 2 square, 0 minus 7 square, minus 1 square, minus 5 square, 1 plus 25, root 26 unit. BD 5 minus 2 whole square, we can add plus 3 minus 4 square, 7 square minus 1 square, 49 plus 1, root 50. So AC not equal to BD means diagonal not equal. So ABCD is not a rectangle. Okay? Means sides, opposite sides equal, so parallelogram, but diagonal is not equal, so it's not a rectangle. Pause the video, note down.